Hey guys, what is up? And welcome to another episode of Pokemon Legends Red. Today we'll take on the Cerulean City Gym. So looking at the overworld sprite, Misty has a Gyarados. Definitely it will be a Mega Gyarados, if I'm right. I did a little training off screen yesterday. And toxicity made it to 32 that fast. As you can see, I added a new team member. It's Ralts, a female Ralts. I plan on making it evolve into a Gardevoir for the psychic fairy type coverage. For the Dreadnought, Venusaur is the only one who can handle it with Razor Leafs. Cerulean City's gym trainers are all level 29. So Misty most likely has a level 30 and above Pokemon. And so Carvskar made it to 30-30. And it's learning Sky Attack. So why not? It's better than Peck, so I'll replace that. Venusaur as well made it to 33. Ralts made it to 20. Will definitely evolve into Cerulean now. Might as well heal up. Since it will definitely be a Mega Gyarados, I'll plan on saving up toxicity for it. So I'll put up Venusaur first. I'm wondering if I made the right choice. and definitely a wrong choice. Her first one is the Gyarados already. I'll whip up the leech seed. I'll whip up a super potion for Venusaur. Maybe I'll try with Toxtricity now since the HP is down to half. And the Thunderbolt made a crit. Frogadier making it to 33 already. Rabboot to 27. Cramorant is up next. Good going for Toxtricity. It one hit the Cramorant with its Thunderbolt. So this time it's a Crawdont. Cerulean making it to 21. Calm Mind, it's good for raising the special attacks. That was fairly easy, I guess. My toxicity was a monster back there in Cerulean Gym. So now let's proceed to this place. So, all right. I'll save here for now. I put up Carb Square first, and that was a very wrong idea because this Morpeko is an electric type. Might as well use the Venusaur. Okay, that wasn't something I expected. This Morpeko is a huge monster. Snap out of it. Oh my gosh, this is the worst. Okay, Toxicity managed to defeat it despite the confusion and having 7 HP. A Sand Scorch. This will be a job for either Frogadier or Corpsquire. I'll go for Frogadier on this. The Sand Scorch is the final evolution of the Sizzlipede that I have a few episodes back before getting the Score Bunny. And with that, Toxicity is at 33. So now then I'll heal up. Now that we're finally done with everything needed here in Cerulean City, I'll proceed to here. Since there are tall grasses here, I just want to check it out. And there's a Dreepy. I wanted to get one, but the Corpse Squirrel will definitely try and kill it, so I'll use Toxtricity. I just wanted to get one if ever I tried to change my mind and wanted to use a Ghost and Dragon type. But this Dreepy already has a Dragon Claw and it's just level 10. I better use the Pokeball in the next turn. It will definitely faint. Okay, that was a bummer. I'll just find another one. Okay, this is a cute fun. The pre-evolved form of Cooperaha. Okay, there's another Dreepy. Maybe I'll have a fair share of another chance with this. Dragon Claw will not be affected. Cerulea will not be affected by the Dragon Claw since it's a fairy type as well. And definitely the Drippy will faint in the next turn. Maybe I'll just have to come back and try again some other time. I'll teleport back to Cerulean for now. I'll stock up on a few Pokeballs. Okay. I think this is the first daycare house. Yes, I was right. I really wanted to try on getting the Drippy, so I'll have a go at it again. Okay, that was not really what I'm expecting. Okay, there's a female one. I wonder if I can get this right now. If I'll be using the Drippy, I'm wondering which one of the six will be the one that I need to replace. Okay, I really didn't. try using Cerulean. This drip is really taking up too much of my time. I'll try luck with the Pokeball since it's already on red and it's still one. Since I really can't seem to catch one for now, I'll just come back here when I have a great bowler or something else. I don't want catching the Dreepy to take up so much of the time. Or maybe I'll try catching one later off screen. So let's proceed now to onwards to Vermillion City. Okay, to the underground path. Okay. We just made it to the other side. There's quite a few trainers. I'll try skipping out some of the others so that I can train up. So I can use them to train up. And the first Pokemon I found was a wild Draco that was level 12. And there's another one that's level 13 near its evolution. Okay, I'll save for now and I'll try to take on these two. It seems that there's lots of Dracos in here. This will definitely be a Mega Pinsir, so it's a good thing that I have Corv Squire first. And I didn't know that it's level 36. It's quite too much. if the male camper has a mega pincer, I think the female camper will have the mega heracross or a mega scissor maybe. It's good that Carb Square was able to tank that. Okay, making Rabbit to 28. It's learning counter. Will that be a good choice? Okay, not for now because that was, using counter was a gamble. Okay, clearly at 22, I guess. It's a Fero, definitely for toxicity. Okay, Curb Square at 34. Frog there as well. Venusaur as well. The trainers that I skipped out in this route, I'll come back for them. I'll use them as training for my team. It's definitely a mega Pidgeot. So I'll try switching out to Toxtricity while it's mega evolving. Okay, that was some good damage. It's an orbital. I'll try luck with Corp Square. I don't know if Corp Square can still handle it since it already has a 12 HP left. It managed to defeat the orbital. But the future site will definitely hit Corp Square if I don't switch it out. Okay, I think that, alright, the future side killed my Toxtricity, and I kind of felt bad since Toxtricity will made it to 34 already if it didn't faint. So, Frogadier. Okay, that was really annoying. I should have used water pulse instead. Okay, good job with the confusion. Okay, Rabut making it to 29. 23 for Trelia. Okay, now we reached 'Vermillion City. We'll heal up and okay, this NPC right here gave us the VAS Seeker already. So we can rebattle a few trainers. Okay. We'll save up for now. And I have to end this part right here. I'll train and take on the trainers that I skipped out off screen, and I'll make sure to level up. So thank you guys for watching. Stay safe out there, and I'll see you in the next one.